Do you actually dislike Jake Paul?
I would say I'm more indifferent to Jake. I think there's a part of me that still thinks what he's doing is kind of an act or, a show he puts on. I'd say if who he acts like is his real person, then yeah, he's probably kind of a shit person. But I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. Maybe it's just an act.
And if he
But
was to
even
win.
wait, hold on. Even if he was a shit person, I guess I would still be pretty indifferent to that. I mean, there's a lot of shit people in the world.
And if you were to win on Saturday, a lot of people would thank you because there's a lot of hatred towards Jake Paul.
I actually think, we should probably have our contracts reversed. I'm sure Jake's getting some type of pay-per-view bonus, and I'm carrying the fucking promotion of this fight. Jake ain't promoting shit. Well, you go look on Fight TV. Jake's got 50,000 views, and I got 1.2 million. Triller, maybe they can send me a couple million-dollar bonus afterwards, because the promotion of this fight is squarely on my shoulders. Jake's not doing his job. Frankly, it's been a bloodbath. If we're talking trash talk, it's not even a 10-8. It's more like a 10-7 or a guy. I don't think we've seen a 10-6 in mixed martial arts, but something like that. And it's just this guy has he only picks the lowest hanging fruit because his audience average age is 13 and a half. And like the lowest hanging fruit just isn't going to work against me. You're going to have to come with something creative or something intelligent. He just has lacked the ability to do so. I really liked how Tyson bit that dude, so maybe I'll try to bite Jake.
And just finally from you, can I get your prediction, please, on for the fight night?
I seventh round TKO, we'll stick with that.
Brilliant. All the best then.
Thanks.
Thanks, Ben.
I mean, from the first time we did anything, no one likes the guy. I was blown away. Like I'd never seen not even as many people hate Colby Covington. Like I have literally never seen anything like it. So I can't say it's swaying more because I think it was swayed in the beginning.
Ben, you can say whatever you want.
Okay, good. Listen, I fully intend to box on Saturday night, but Jake Paul is telling lies when he says my purse will be deducted for me doing a non-MMA, a non-boxing move. That's just not true. He made it up, and I would just appreciate all you guys write that he's telling lies. Peace.
Well, from the people who really dislike Jake Paul, they count on you to count him out of the boxing game. Do you realize that feeling from some of the fans?
Yeah, I mean, I honestly think I think most fans are more invested in the result of this bout than I am. I mean, for me, I think actually the biggest negative comes from winning because if I beat Jake Paul's, I'm gonna be like world famous, and I ain't really trying to be world famous. Yeah, it's good to have that support, and Jake Paul is tremendous in the fact that he even made Dana White like me, which, man. That's years. That took years to make it happen. He made it happen. So good job, Jake Paul. Well, yes, my audience is growing, and I've already commented that I'm carrying the promotion of this fight, and Jake Paul's not doing his job. You know what I think it all points to, and I don't want to be famous, but it points to the fact that there's so many not authentic people in the world, and when someone's just real with them, when someone just really says how he feels from the bottom of his heart, people appreciate that. And I think that's kind of the biggest thing that's coming through is. People thought maybe it was bravado or something. No, I'm just being me, and I've been me for the last 20 years. And we don't see a lot of real people in the world, and the authenticity people appreciate. So create some type of personality for yourself, and then I would say on the second side is like I grew up. Muhammad Ali was my favorite athlete, and so he used psychological warfare to his advantage. And I can tell you unequivocally whether it was my wrestling career, my mixed martial arts career, is that. Yeah, when the other guy's really angry or emotional, it's so beneficial. I mean, it really, really helps a lot. And actually, I kind of told someone that night, and they pointed out, which is an obvious point, is Jose Aldo versus Conor McGregor. Like Conor was so far under his skin, and that was the reason the fight was so easy for him, is he made Jose mad. So not only would it be beneficial from a promotional standpoint, but it's actually beneficial from a competition standpoint. And so yeah, go get started figuring it out.
Jake actually said he wanted to wrestle you. So will you accept that challenge, and how quickly would that fight go?
I cannot figure out. I always try to think of what is someone's angle on this. I can't figure out what his angle is. I don't know. I mean, yeah, if he wants to wrestle, we can wrestle. He wasn't even good at high school wrestling. The notion that I couldn't pin him in 20 seconds is hilarious. So I don't really know. I don't really know what he's angling at there. And then, but the one thing it does make me think is which I've kind of always thought, and this I guess would be further proof that he realizes he doesn't have a future in boxing. If your goal was to be a great boxer, you're not going to take a couple months off to wrestle somebody. You know, I just think back to my time, and I'm a world class athlete, and he's Jake Paul. I remember my time in 2010. I tried to both wrestle and do mixed martial arts. I was in the Bellator tournament, and it sucked. And I was not optimal in either one because I was splitting my time. So, yeah, I don't understand the angle there.
Would you prefer to win on Saturday night and have a lot of praise from people who dislike Jake Paul, yeah, or would you prefer of that win over Jorge Masvidal?
That's good. Well, I would pick, obviously, if I could rewind history, to beat Masvidal, because if I beat Masvidal, I was fighting for the UFC title, and that was pretty much the only belt in mixed martial arts that I didn't win. So I would obviously reverse that.
Ben, when you started this training camp, you know, when you were striking for MMA, you were striking to set up takedowns. You were striking to get to your wrestling. But you said that, you know, 3 months you would have time to learn and adapt and grow. How much do you feel like you have learned and adapted and grown, you know, in your boxing over these last 3 months?
Well, you guys saw it yesterday, right? I mean, read the comments on that video. There's millions of views. Go read the comments. Yeah, people saw it. And that was cut. That was my whole premise is I understand that I suck at this, but I understand I'm a world-class athlete, and despite the fact that I don't look like it, right? Sometimes can't judge a book by the cover. And that I'm a world-class learner. I understand how to learn things really well. And I understand, give me 11 weeks at trying this, and I'm going to be way better. And that's what you guys saw. Yeah, I don't really intend to box after Saturday night. But, no, it's not a who question. It's a how much question. Is Triller going to recognize that I'm going to sell them a million pay-per-views and cut me, you know, a Conor McGregor-type check for the next one? Because if they do, then I would consider doing it again. And if they don't, I love coaching wrestling and podcasting. That's kind of my passion in life. I'll probably just go and do that.
Well, a Conor McGregor-like check would include Conor McGregor, right?
Oh, I can't imagine the UFC. Well, Conor's a significantly better boxer than myself and obviously Jake Paul as well. I would love to fight Conor McGregor in mixed martial arts, but again, I'm going to be retired, and yeah, I just don't really see all that happening. I'm just saying, you asked me how I would do this again, and how I would do this again is if they give me a very large amount of money. When I signed the Jake Paul fight, I was sitting on the fucking couch for 15 months, but when I got done with the UFC in October of 2019, I remember I tried to go do some private lessons, and it was just like literally too painful, and I couldn't do it. So I had been doing some yoga and some bicycle, and then after my surgery, I did nothing. And so literally, I started putting out footage of me hitting nothing for 15 months, being not working out for 15 months, and it was not pretty. And I just knew, I had faith in myself that if I put my mind to it for 11 weeks, it's gonna get a lot better, and it got a lot better. And then you combine that with the fact that I've never actually focused on boxing, and I'm a quick learner, and I tend to be good at those type of things when I put my mind to it. Yeah, obviously, for what you're looking at, you got a lot better product in week 11 than you did in week one. So I actually think betting on this fight is very risky, which, hey, some people love risk. And I think a lot of people just want to say, I bet on this fight because they want to have an opinion one way or the other. But compared to, like, for me, just as a gambler, you know, the fights that I want to bet on are the ones where I'm like, dude, I've seen these dudes fight 20 times. I know exactly what they're going to do. I understand both their strengths and both their weaknesses, and I understand how they fit together, right? When I look at MMA fights that I